Welcome to our grower workshop. Today I'm going to show you how to install a Sensia shower toilet using the Pro version. Let's get started. First, let's check what's in the box besides the bowl. Of course, it doesn't hurt to take a look at the enclosed installation manual. And here is another overview of the tools you will need. So, let's get started. The power supply should be switched off from the outset. Firstly, remove the mounting template and adjust the threaded bolts to a distance of 58 mm from the finished wall. Then check the power cable. This must be 300 mm in length and installed in advance by a specialist. Next, open the inspection shaft to fit the connection hose. To do this, remove the retaining ring and the nut from the hose. Don't remove the protective cap yet. Then guide the hose through the Rapid SLX. Now check that the angle valve is closed and tighten if necessary. Then remove the filling valve hose from the angle valve. After that, fit the hose to the T-joint and screw it to the angle valve with the seal. Now it's time to remove the protective cap from the hose, then fit the nut and retaining ring first. Next, connect the hose to the T-joint. Now remove the lower cap from the hose. Close the ball valve and tighten the nuts if necessary. Then open the angle valve and carry out a check to ensure everything is watertight. Now open the ball valve and flush out the hose. Then close the valve again. Now it's time to prepare the flush and drain pipe. These are included with the wall hung element. Fit the seals, then adjust the length of the pipes to suit the bowl. Then press both pipes into the element. The noise protection sheet can also be attached now. Simply put it over the pipes and threaded bolts. Now slide the bowl onto the finished wall at a distance of 100 mm. Feed the water hose and the power cable through the bowl. And then slide the bowl over the threaded bolts. Next, assemble the mounting set as shown here and slide it over the bolts. Then tighten the nuts by hand. Check everything with the spirit level and tighten firmly. Make sure here that the bolts are flush with the nut. Finally, remove the bowl mounting aid. Now it can be flushed and checked for water tightness. Perfect. The noise protection sheet can now be cut flush. And silicone can be applied around the bowl. Next, insert the plug-in nuts to secure the technical unit. Now connect it to the power cable. To do this, plug in the cable and tighten it. Then insert the water hose into the technical unit and secure it with a white clip. Let it audibly snap into place. And open the ball valve. Then open the angle valve and do another check for water tightness. Now insert the technical unit into the bowl and push it into the fastening position. Then open the lid and check the position is correct. Next, remove the lid. Insert the screws and tighten them using the Phillips screwdriver. Then replace the lid. Finally, the power connector is placed on the tray under the bowl. The inspection shaft must first be severed completely flush with the wall, so that the flush plate does not protrude over the edge of the tiles later on. Then install it according to the TPI. Snap it in place. Done. The power connection can now be turned back on. Next, insert the batteries into the remote control to connect it to the technical unit. To do this, remove the lid. Switch on the unit and replace the lid. Then press and hold the power button on the back of the remote control for 2 seconds to switch it on. Then press and hold the stop button for 3 seconds to initiate pairing. If pairing is successful, all LED lights on the remote control will flash 3 times. Now carry out another test on everything and check for water tightness. To do this, first insert the spray hood into the toilet seat and close it. Then test the rear spray and lady shower functions. Once the functions have been checked, press the stop button. Finally, remove the spray hood and test that the dryer works using the dryer button. Perfect. The nightlight can now be activated. To do this, press and hold the stop and temperature plus buttons for 2 seconds. Now it's time for the handover. Before the job's done, there are still a few things left to check. Job well done.